Style and substance. These two has advocates the brand that epitomize style and substance. Please put your hands together for the very lovely Soha Ali Khan and the super multi-talented Neha Dhundla.
Now time to invite on. men must be coming up to you all the time saying we're scared to shave. Not in the middle of this, Chief, please. Please. They must be coming up to you saying we're scared to shave. There are a lot of misconceptions. Clearly these three women aren't, but there are women who come up to you saying that in terms of hair removal lotions. They're chemicals, so they're burning your hair, they're burning your skin as well, right? So those are much more harmful. So the most physical, inert, non-troubling or non-harming gadget is a razor. And then when you have razors such as these, which are newer and modern, you have the added benefits. Like you said, nicotine cuts. This will never give you a nicotine cut because if you see the edges, they're more rounded, the blades are smooth, and they're mounted on a spring. The nicotine cut happens when you're holding the razor and you're not too sure how much pressure you need to apply, and then along the contours of your body, when you're turning it along, is where you end up getting nicotine cuts because it's not flexible. In this, the neck and the head are flexible. It's mounted on a spring. So even if you were to put an extra pressure on the handle, that's only transfer on your knees, on the sides of the head.
That's where you get the knees back.
So it just bends so beautifully and flexes itself that it's nice to shave so you don't get the nicks and cuts. And then there's strings, and there's a one beautiful feature about this one. It has a bar, gel bar, which moisturizes.
Wow. I was telling the girls earlier, I think this you can have a bath with this. It's a multi-purpose thing. Right. What are the other myths connected with shaving, as far as shaving towards?
Maybe that hair grows a lot more thicker, which again is not true.
Yes.
That's
again, say it again, once more. A lot of women think that the hair grows thicker, but it is.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't.
Yeah.
Like, for example, when you're waxing or when you're using any other methods for hair removal, you yank it from the root. So when it is growing, it grows from the root and it kind of becomes tapered as it is coming out. So you think that it is thinner or finer. But when you razor or cut through a blade, you're cutting at the surface. So you're chopping it like the bark, like the trunk of a tree. So that feels rough until it tapers off naturally. That's all it is. So it's not actually growing thicker, it just feels blunt and, you know, prickly for that first couple of days.
Because where it's actually been taken out from, as opposed to waxing. What are the other myths? Are there any other myths connected with the...
It's like probably it gives you pigmentation.
I've heard people say that, oh, it makes my skin darker.
Right. It doesn't. It's because if you had razors which were probably not so technologically advanced, you would probably scrape your skin 2-3 times to get away the hair much nearer to the skin. But here there are multiple blades. So one blade is designed to kind of pull your hair a little, the second one cuts off, the third one goes as near to the skin as possible. So with one stroke, you're getting a much better hair removal experience. And two, there's also these bars, which are fortifying it, or rather giving you the moisture.